Well, since the last time we made a video, we've installed these custom-made cocoa mats from Cocoa Mat. Very, very nice. Excellent company to deal with. Just kind of giving you a reminder of this car. Walk around over here. Look at the back. Lovely cocoa mats. And you can see everything's working in this car. Dome light, courtesy light down there at the driver's, as well as the rear dome light. Walk around again. Of course, the new custom exhaust system. Wood, the glass, cocoa mats. Yes, very lovely 4.5. Let's go ahead and just take this car for a ride. This will be his maiden voyage as far as videos are concerned. So let's get
all right.
Start it up. Bosch D-tronic electronic fuel injection. First in the world in a production car. We'll take her out. Three-speed automatic transmission, torque converter. What is it like driving a late 72 Mercedes Benz 280SE with a 4.5 liter V8 in it and a 3-speed automatic? Well, it's really nice. It's sublime. It shifts very smoothly. We're already in third gear, doing 45 miles an hour at about 2,000 RPMs at this point. And at 60, it's just shy of 3,000, maybe 2,800 RPMs. As you can hear, no rattles in the car. And this is not a smooth as glass country road. The steering is very light and responsive. There's no wandering, shake, rattle, or roll in the steering. However, it's not dead. You have lots of feedback in the steering wheel itself. You can just barely feel it just with the ripples of the road, which is a nice feature because so many times in these big luxury cars, or even smaller cars, especially modern cars, you do lose that feel of the road. In this car, you do not. It's all about how you drive the car. These things were set up to be driven fast, and they can be, especially with that nice rear end ratio. The 200 horsepower is immediately on tap, and you can feel it. I have two six-cylinder Mercedes, a W108 and a W111, and this thing is so much more powerful. With its 200 horsepower compared to the other two. The view out the windshield is just sublime. It's this lovely hood, the star, all the scenery reflecting in the paint. I love all the noises, the mechanical noises, which tell you everything is okay. Just take this sharp turn here. It was designed for 15, we just did it at 30. No drama there at all. The new exhaust system I installed really allows me to hear what's going on up front, which is lovely. Before it was just a rumbling, loud truck. There is a little bit of wind whistling right over here, and these side vents can be adjusted, and so I might end up doing that at some point. I don't know if you can hear it, but it's just a little bit. And we're moving along now at about 50 miles an hour. The handling of this car is such that it does encourage you to be hot through the corners if you want. This car, of course, has absolutely no nanny devices, not even ABS. It's all about you, the driver. This car was built back in the day, as far as the German point of view, was that quality, or at least luxury, was founded in quality of construction. And man, you can feel that all around you when you drive a well-set-up W108. They have their design has stood the test of time, and they're just incredibly modernistic sorts of cars in terms of how far ahead they were in their day as far as their chassis design and suspension, and which makes them feel so modern today.
Thank you.